guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way.
Oh, I know that my Redeemer liveth, that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worn destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God.
Thank you.
go in order as it is written. Prayer by Reverend Evelyn Wallace, Old Testament Scripture by Minister Irene Cantrell, New Testament Scripture, Reverend Evelyn Wallace.
Family, let me say, I know this is a solemn time, but in all things, the scripture says that we should rejoice. So we rejoice today, not as those that have lost a loved one, but we rejoice in knowing that the God that we serve is able. Let us pray. Father, most gracious, most merciful, and everlasting God, Lord, we bow before you right now, and God, you know and you see that our hearts are heavy, but God, you said in your word that you would lift up a bowed down head. So God, we ask that you touch now, that you move among these family and friends. Oh God, that you touch in a mighty way. Comfort right now, dear Master. Your word says that weeping would endure for a night, but joy would come in the morning. So God, we ask you now to turn the weeping into morning time, and to wipe tears from weeping eyes. God, we ask now that you strengthen us where we are weak. And dear Master, build us up where we are torn down. God, we need you to be our leading pole right now. We cannot stand in our own strength, but God, in the strength and the power of your precious Holy Spirit, we ask now, dear God, that you prop us up, build us up on every weak and leaning side. And then, dear God, we ask now that you touch this family as only you can touch. For God, we realize that you know all things, and we know, dear God, that you don't make mistakes. Now that you comfort, I ask now, dear God, that you move as only you can move. Touch to me. Oh God, in her weakest hours, strengthen her right now. Touch Jane, touch Matt, touch Sarah. Touch Joyce. Tears from weeping eyes right now. And because you see the hearts right now, dear Master, you know that they are broken, but you are even a mender of broken hearts. So Father, we give this burden to you because you told us to cast our cares on you. So God, we cast this burden on you today. We cast these cares on you today. God, we ask now that as you touch, as you move, that you would just hold us, keep us right now, dear Master. God, we thank you for what you're doing. We give you glory. God, we honor you in all things, even in this. We honor you today, God. And we thank you for it now. We give it all to you. In the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, we do pray.
Yes.
Amen.
tell us.
Old Testament scripture by Minister Irene Cantrell, Alphaline. New Testament by Reverend Evelyn Wallace.
To our Heavenly Father, we just thank God for this day and this occasion. It's a sad occasion, but we thank God for this day. Thank you, Lord, for all your many wonderful blessings. And our Old Testament scripture would come from Psalms 91. He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wastes in noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. I've read for you 9 verses of Psalms 91. May the Lord as a blessing to the readers and hearers of his word and doers of his word. Amen. Thank you to the family.
New Testament reading from the book of Revelations, chapter 21, beginning at verse number 1. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, Tootie, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. May you be encouraged, knowing that God's word does not lie, because God is his word. So know that God said in his word that he will make all things new.
Amen. At this time, we have reflection of family and friends. After that, we have a selection, musical selection by Jakira Sir.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I say, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I say, praise the Lord, everybody. God is good, and God is good all by himself. Beside him, there is no other. I just want to thank y'all. Thank God for today. I want to thank God for my brother's life. In the year 1973, at 20 years old, my brother was paralyzed from the waist down. The night he had the accident, my daddy called home and told us, because my daddy went to Albany, and he called home and told us that the doctor said, if he make it through the night, he might live. That's when I found out about prayer. Because my mama had us all praying. We stayed up all night long praying and calling on the name of Jesus. And I never forget the words my mama said. She asked God, if he let her child live any kind of way he came back to her, she would be satisfied. And the Lord answered her prayer. That's why I said we owe God a hand clap of praise today, God. We owe him a hand clap of praise. We owe him. We owe him a hand clap of praise. My brother was paralyzed for 50 years. But I thought about something this morning. I was listening at my church song, and the songwriter said, I moved out this old house and to a brand new home. Ain't no leaking in his house. It's not raining. Ain't no hurt in his house. There's no pain. God has done what we asked him to do. So we got to be satisfied with the result. 50 years.
My sister looked like we were on the exact same page. But when I came down, that's exactly what I was going to say. I wanted to, I'm saddened, but I'm thankful. Because as she said, we prayed that prayer.
Yeah.
You know, when he had that accident at Cordele Concrete 50 years ago, you know, we prayed, Lord, don't let him die. Just give him some more time. Don't let him die at this young age. And look at what he did. He gave him 50 more years. You know, he gave them the life that a lot of folks have been born and they died.
Yeah.
You understand? A lot of people have come here, they gone in the span of the time that the Lord gave him, in addition to a very traumatic, very traumatic and very serious accident. So we are grateful, and he was, the Bible promises 70. He was just about at the door.
Yeah.
You understand? A few months, he would be turning 70 years of age. So saddened, but at the same time, grateful that God gave him this much additional time in his life. And he had an opportunity to go on and have kids and grandkids. You understand? So he had a chance to go on and live a life of happiness and have offsprings. They've got offsprings. So we're just grateful. And the other thing is being grateful for all of you that are here today that is supporting the family. This is a being on during the week, in the middle of the week, it's hard to get out of jobs and responsibilities. So those of you who are here, we're just grateful and thank you for all of the support that's here and those that are not here, the ones that have called, the ones who've sent words of encouragement, text messages, and the whole thing. Thank you, and thank each and every one of you and all of your respective places and all of you in the ministry, people that have just been supporting. Thank you.
Amen.
it's a sad occasion, but you know, like Matt and Joy said, it's been 50 years. And I was part of that 50 years. And I just thank God that he didn't die when he fell off that scaffold. And I thank God that my daughter had the opportunity, because she wasn't even born yet. I'm glad she had the opportunity to know her father. And they had a close, very close relationship. And I wasn't mad about that. I encouraged it because he was a good father. He was a good man. And I just thank God for letting him live this long. But you know, God knows best. And he knows when we get enough. He knows when the suffering needs to stop. And I think his suffering has stopped. He needed some rest.
Yes.
He had suffered long enough. And I just thank God for him. We was high school sweethearts, you know. But things happen. I just thank God for my daughter and her daddy. They had a very close relationship. And I thank God for that. Thank you.
Praise God, everybody. I'm so glad that God brought my auntie Ernie and Sarah Wilson together, because well, for that, I wouldn't have met one of them. He wasn't my biological uncle, but he was my uncle. And we were very, very close. And I just loved him so much. And the last day they said, before that, he just kept asking about me, because we were really, really close. And I just pray that he's, you know, he ain't suffering no more. That's a good thing. He ain't suffering no more. And I always love him. Y'all pay my respect to the Lord.
Thank you.
selection by Ms. Jakira Sutton.
Good evening, everyone. This is to the family. I hope that this blesses you. There's been times when I felt in doubt, but I didn't give up, even though I gave out. Seems like storm and loss got all in my way, but the road got longer the more.
Now, many of y'all
y'all might not know this, but he had about three names that I know of. Family called him Wimp. They called him Wimp in school. But when he married my sister, she called him Wendell. So he was Wilmer, he was Wilmer, and he was Wendell. So I might be calling them all three today, but thank God for him, because he was when he came into my life, he stayed close from then all the way up to now. I remember I used to, when he was going up to Warm Springs, Georgia, to learn a trade. Take him up there, and me and him talk and just kind of enjoy ourselves for that couple hour drive that you can get there. Mm-hmm. And but after he got this trade, he was trying to learn how to do it. He told himself, be a mechanic. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's all right. But you know one thing about it. That you could work on. He worked on his car, even though he had problem with it, paralyzed from waist down. He still could fix his car. Right. And I would ride with him. He still could drive. He still could drive. I would ride with him one day, and use that crutch. I think that's what you call it, a hand crutch. And he used it for the gas and the brake. And we was at a stop sign, a red light or something, and when the light changed, he got ready to go, he hit it. He said, look at that. He had spinning wheels, and then he hit the brakes. I said, man, you pretty good with that crutch. I wasn't afraid of anything because I knew he had it. Amen. But that was wonderful, you know. He did what he could, you know. While he could. And I just enjoyed being my brother-in-law. Amen.
Yes, yes.
But about in times such as this, a funeral, we need assurance more than ever before. Assurance that there really is something beyond this world.
Yes.
Assurance that one day everything wrong shall be made right again through Christ Jesus our Lord. When times are tough, when we are faced with tragedy, we are often overwhelmed with grief and sorrow. Even with the deep sadness we feel, we can find comfort and promise in eternal Jesus. Amen. I thought about it. This funeral for Wilson is a time to honor and mourn life that has been lost. But it's also a time to celebrate hope. Of the reunion of eternity and the comfort that brings. It's hard to lose memory. It's hard. But it also want to remind us that there's much to take comfort as well. Comfort in knowing that heaven is really our true home. Jesus assured us that when he said in John 14, he said, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, you believe also in me. My Father's house is many mansions. And if it were not so, I would not have told you that I'm going away to prepare a place for him. He said, I'll come back and take you to be with me, and that you also may be where I am. He said, you know the way, the place where I'm going. He tells us that I stay here on earth is only for a time, and that a reunion in heaven is guaranteed for us when our lives here on earth come to an end. I know we've heard many times that everybody's not going to die. Some will get caught up in the rapture when Jesus comes. One thing about Brother Wendell, he went on before the rapture came, but he understood, and he understood that, amen, that he served a God that gave him a long life. I thought about when he fell off of that elevator at the concrete place. I thought about it. I said, because when he fell, the height he fell, and what he fell on would have took an average person. But like Sister Joyce said, prayer changes things.
Yeah.
And God gave him some more life. And he got a chance to see his children to be grown. He got a chance to see his grandchildren to be grown. He also has some great-grand. But I come to not to hold you long, but don't let your heart be troubled. John, he tells us in John that heaven is guaranteed. He said, but it's in a place of a perfect peace and a place of joy.
Yes.
He's absent from all pain. Yes. He's absent from all suffering.
Yes.
Amen. I can feel the spirit of Brother Wendell in here today, and I know as much as we miss him, but I don't believe if he had the chance to come back right now, I believe he'll tell us that that's all right.
Yeah.
I'm all right now. I'm in a place, amen, that I know that I'm in a place where God wants me to be at peace. I'm in a place where I'm not going, I don't have all of that pain and all of the hurt. I don't have to deal with the troubles of this world. Right about now.
Right.
I'm in the presence of my mother, my father, my sisters, and my brothers. I'm in my aunts and my uncles. I'm in a place where there's peace. In addition to the promise of heaven being our true home, taking comfort in Christ, love is a second source of comfort. Christ promised to never abandon or to leave us alone to grieve. He has taken all of the pain, all of the sorrows, and the grief upon himself. We see that in God's promises of the coming Messiah found in Isaiah. Surely he has borne of grief and carried our sorrow.
Yes.
Yet we esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But Jesus give us a refuge and a place of comfort during our more difficult time, like today. As much as they hurt through him, we are able to find joy and strength in the midst of sadness. We find comfort in the love and support of those that's around us in these moments of difficulty. We draw strength from family. We draw strength from friends. And as they help us remember the best of wisdom. John 14, Jesus said, I'll not leave you comfortless. He said, I come to you. And it isn't just a promise that he'll never leave us. It's a reminder that Jesus is our comfort.
Yes.
And he's our peace.
Yes.
He'll provide us with support that we need to continue on and to keep going. He'll help us in this. Yes, it's kind of hard.
Right along in there.
But one thing about it, you can always count on Christ. You can always count on God. Because he got a shoulder that we all can lean on. He got long that he can all wrap around all of us at the same time. Because he is the comfort during the time of life.
He promised that
eternity.
But also,
let's remember that heaven is our true home. Not here on earth, when we have to deal with all the cares of the world. But heaven is our true home.
Take comfort in Christ, Lord, for us. Draw strength from
the love and the support for those that's around. Let be reminded of the hope of the resurrection. You know the resurrection that, amen, that's going to take place. Oh, it's going to take place. Amen. That dead will rise again. That's Christ's love for us, amen. We have to support one another, amen, and comfort each other as best we can. And leave the comfort that you know that Christ will. Amen. They said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Okay, you still can look to one another, but always look to the hill from which comes your help. Every now and then, you're going to have to drop down on the Lord.
That you comfort us in your soul.
Like a river, attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. The family of Mr. Wendell Whitest is most appreciative for all the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that have been shown to them during this time of sorrow. They ask for your continued prayers in the days ahead. May each of you continue in the blessings. The following sympathy cards and floor arrangements have been sent to the family. Memories of the happiness you shared with your loved one will always be a part of you. With thoughts of heartfelt sympathy, thinking of you, making transition to center. Wishing you strength for today and confident in days ahead, knowing how much you love one next. Believing that your faith, your inner strength, and the power of God's love will carry you through. And deepest sympathy to Devon, from Stephanie, to Rhonda, and to Tanya. To you and yours in sympathy, to the Whitest family, Danielle Brown. With deepest sympathy, the Contrail family. Just to remind you, you're not alone. The thoughts are with you, memories surround you, and friends are all around you. We love you, Joyce. Dot Butts Taylor, Pamela Lane Colson, Jackie Whitehead Brown. With deepest sympathy, Joyce and Matthew Whitest. We love you, Aunt Annie, Eva, Lucy, and Wallace. With deepest sympathy, people of Faith Christian Church family, Apostle Marvis Jones, the pastor. We love Dr. White and Joyce. The beautiful spring that the Lord's brother, uncle, husband, and friend, love the family. And love the memory of Dr. Nicole Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Harvey, CEO and President, and the J.W. Williams Funeral Home staff, who would like to present to this family an African American Family Arrow Bible, in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. The scripture tells us that we may rule for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The J.W. of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will forever remember.